I'm in my guild hall. Thought I'd show you around my guild hall. I know Oki's been round it. I did have somebody here, but then I got all the stuff back in the mail the other day. Was a bit confused about that, but never mind. The portal's gone back, so now I've got a place to put somewhere else. I'm waiting for Anios. Actually, I think I shall go and show you what I did, if I can still get to it. Go to housing. Yes, I can. We're gonna go there. Enter. This is what I done for Annie, I call her Annie, for Christmas. And I'll show you all the best bits that I really absolutely love. Okay. I'm just going to turn you around so you can't see until it's loaded up. I'm going to be quiet. Quieter, anyway, because it is rather late. I'm going to put this on my YouTube channel as well. I'm so proud of this place. I love it. I love it so much. Right, okay. Well, I'm in an uncanny estate. Okay? You can get to it via the leaderboard. Not sure if it's on where it is actually. I don't know if it's on the Halls of Fate. Halls of Fame, sorry. Yay, there is. It's number 20. There is. Okay, so if you want to get to it, I'm on Skyfire. It's in the Halls of Fame. Creativity Reason, number 20. Annie's Christmas Gift. Designed by moi. Okay. Here we are. It's a winter Christmas scene as you enter. Let's go forward this way first. You may be able to hear the spooky noises, you may not, I don't know. But this is the entrance. Before I finish this actual video, what I shall do is take you to one of the houses that at the very end. Take you to one of the houses that this is actually originally in and show you the room that we're actually in. Anyway, this is my little gardeny bit, or I should say her little gardeny bit. Yep, she's got turkey ready for Christmas dinner, and some pumpkins, and some pomegranates. They're a bit rotten because they've been outside all winter, look. And a couple of flying horses. These were hers, so I made it a little stable. Some apples in a bucket, and a bit of a tinkery mappy thing, some equipment, and then there's a bale with some straws and some traps for mice, because there is some mice up here. Look, they caught a mouse. It's a moving crate. Hidey hole for a tiny little person. Okay. And then over here, you've got snow people. Because it's snowing, obviously. And here you've got moi. And I'm saying, welcome to SSHHS 2016. Happy Frostfell. Come in, come in, Come in from out the cold. Take your outside wear off before you go into the house, please, in the front hall here. There is also a Frostfell card to read on the shelf for more information. This is what I was wearing when I done it. And here I put three lights together, one on top of another to give them a more, instead of just blue, green and red, the colours actually stand out a lot better. But there's a cabiny area bit there, coal for the fire, it's a Christmas tree, rainbow twinkles. There you go, see? Oops. Rainbow twinkles. Anyway, it's getting out of the cold. So, in here. Oops. As you can see, that's a doohickey. There's a chair so that you can take your shoes off. Here's the Frostfell card that I made for them. I shall let you read it, I won't read it. And they got some more boots, and taking their cloaks off, and there's the door. Yes, it takes you to Guildhall, but it's supposed to be the door takes you into the house. That's where you can put your dirty bits and bobs. New umbrellas, you know, take your umbrella off. I haven't got no umbrellas. Stick your hats here instead of hanging them up on the door there. Okay, so that's that. Oop. And you're going. And that's supposed to be the opposite of the door that you just came in. This is the shield that I actually wear. Where is it? There it is. Shield that I actually wear. Examine. Yep, that's my shield. Had it for years. So yeah, that's on a mannequin stuffed in the wall. If you're wondering how I managed to get it up there, it's actually on a mannequin. But these aren't. These are Jojo's claws. Left and right. Got them for doing the Heritage Quest. I believe it was Heritage Quest. So yeah, I'll put them on there. And then this is a mat. I love this mat. I love it. I really do love it. And Feyenara, she gave me this frame. And we framed it and stuck it on the wall there. So that's Faye's contribution to helping me. Because I'd have just stuck it on the wall, didn't think of framing it. But it looks absolutely stunning framed. And I put these were what the person had in their moving crate when I thingied. And I've left space for them to put more stuff up here. This is, I don't think I made this. No, Annie made it. And so that was in the moving crate when I came in. All this was in the moving crate. Yeah, this is all in the moving crate. I decided to go with the blue colours instead of the normal green. Excuse me. I decided to go with the sort of blue, not to overdo the Christmassy stuff over the top. And this outside window gives you the feeling of a garden outside. And it's Santa's sleigh with a reindeer. snowman. And it's a Christmas tree that twinkles out there as well. I just want us to, and the only reason I can do that is because it's kind of peeking through the window, so. Oops. Yeah, got some drinks and some. Nothing in these particular. There's nothing there. This one actually says. May your sparklies be many, your loams harvest few, and your armour stay shiny. Happy Frostfell to you. And this one says, I baked you a pie, but I ate it. Happy Frostfell. And, oh yeah. And I done the at my Christmas tree, decorated the Christmas tree. They put a picture up for the television. And my first ever tea set I've ever got, I decided to come here with a cup of tea on a nice tea thing. And there's a remote control for the telly. And the sofas that I created for them. This is the book that she wrote, because I put the card downstairs, so this is in response. This is what she wanted. She wanted somewhere warm and inviting, because the place was kind of like a derelict, falling to pieces, dirty, horrible place. So, yeah, she just wanted it completely different, so that's what I've done, my best of my abilities anyway. So yeah, curtains, my first lot of curtains I ever had as well. I got at Halloween, I like them curtains. Some mince pies. Love this coffee table, love it. Apples, new Christmas boxes this year. Oh, excuse me, got him off of Christmas, stuck him under the tree. I love this fish tank. I just love this fish tank. It's got fishes in it as well. Look, fishies. And I bought Tinker thingamabob in there to give it a look like it's got, what do you call it? A filter. You know, like a real one. And it's on that side. You know, to get oxygen in there and filter the water, and there's more fishes there. And well, he's supposed to be doing a swimming, but he decided to take a walk on the bottom of the fish tank. And I thought, well, just leave him in there. He hasn't got a diving helmet on. I like gingerbread men. So we go into the dining area here. And you can see the other side, see through it, so it gives you the illusion of it being open planned front room, dining room, but with a fish tank in the middle, so you can see through. So yeah, and here's my sundaes. This is a strawberry sundae, not strawberry. It's got a red cherry sundae, and a napkin and roast dinner, some veg. And this is a black cherry sundae with some raspberry cream jam on it. And then you've got the window that you're looking out on. Looking out, look, see. And then you've got the kitchen area here with the nuts and fruit. Muffins and some washing up and washing up, draining off, and I put some syrup taps, dysfunctional syrup tap, Two of them as hot and cold taps. Orange slices. And I like this kitchen. For the simple fact, it's simple. They are troll crates. And you've got your eggs in your basket and some blueberries, cooking, baking cookies. And this is actually a real life recipe book that I actually make myself at home. For low carb, high fat, gluten free recipes. Pancakes, fat bombs. I haven't tried the eggnog, but the eggnog is an actual real recipe for low carb, high fat recipe. Gluten free. And then I've got like recipe information. It tells you how to make. Oh crap. Sorry about that. Sorry. Cancel. Didn't mean to swear. Pancakes. Fat bombs. I can't even pronounce that. Coco. Quito. Puerto Rican. Eggnog. It's eggnog. For low carb. Yeah, and then it's a bit of information and some information on there as well. Excuse me, I've got a frog in my throat. Really got to go to bed soon. I think it's got something in it. A fish or something? I think it come with the pot. Egg timer, but my favourite thing is that I've got extractor fan up the top here. I put an extractor fan in so all the heat goes up into the extractor fan at the ceiling. A light in it as well. Cooking some pies for Christmas. Preparing some meat for burgers. Cups and salt and pepper and wine and blender. It's got all the buttons down there. Thingy. Cheese wheel. Vegetables. Spudgeon. And tea towel. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. And you got a freezer, and a fridge, walk-in freezer with a fridge, and then you come to the bedroom, and it's got a cuddly dragon on there, somewhere to take clothes off. This is the bathroom, and the loo with the working water's going up, I see, so you can fill it up. And it's got water in the bowl as well. Another towel, and hot and cold tap, and a bath, not bath, shower, you've got a plug, and you can turn the tap on, and you get a shower, look. Wee! Shower! And you get out, wipe your feet. And then, go around here into the dressing area where you can put. There you go. Put it on there for him. Brr. There you go. I've got trusty access, don't matter. Well, it does, but. And this just says why I left them blank, why I've used. So that I could add more to it. Hat. hairbrush and what have you. More spare blankets and rolls. So yeah. So yeah, I love this place. I love it a lot. And I love these. And then you go up here. And wow. They wanted a reading area, so they've got a nice little comfy chairs where they can sit down with books. These are non-player books, so yeah, little library area. There's a place for them to put more books here, play some musical instruments or something, perhaps a slouch down and flop and go to sleep on the cushion. And then they got your office with another lookout, wherever that takes you. Some flowers, and yeah, the office area. So this is what I done for my Christmas Santa thing. I left these for them to be able to put trophies up, like I've done here or something. So yeah, so that's my them. And then you've got the outside where I welcome you in and welcome you out. So that's what that looks like. But I will show you what this place looks like I shall show you what this place looks like before I log off the area that we were just in, to show you the difference between what I've done and what it was like. So bear with me. Okay, so we were in an uncanny estate, so we will tour uncanny. So we can find the word uncanny estate. There we go. We'll tour that. So if you remember the room with snow and snowmen and the little garden, this is the room with the snow and the snowmen and the garden. So here, this area here, right here, is where the turkey and the scarecrow and the pumpkins are. And then this area here, from here across to here and along here, so this entire area here is where the stable is. And then this area here is where the house bit is, where you go in. And the door to the guild hall is here. Now the ceiling goes up to here, up to the top of the door. The sky might actually be a bit higher than that. So that goes all the way along here. This is all blocked off with a wall, so all of this is covered up. But if we go up here, you can't see none of this because it's all underneath all the flooring. But here, the floor, when you come in, you take the teleporter. When you've got the teleporter and you're on a teleporter, you come out here. So this is where you come out. But the floor, you come out here on top of this here. So this gives you all this room here. This is where the front room is. This area from here to here is the outside, all the way down here, all the way up here. Well, not all the way up there, all the way to about here, actually, to here. That is the outside scenery with the window. And you've got to remember, the floor is here. So we are under the floor, nearest damn it. If you're a fae, you would be under the floor. So it gives you plenty of room to sink stuff and it not fall through the floor. Now, you've also got to remember that all of this is covered in floor. There's no, you can't see it. So the sky comes to here. The floor comes to here, so you can sink stuff in it. So you get to here. This bit here is where the fireplace is and the Christmas tree. And then you've got the fish tank, which takes you to wherever it comes out to here. And then you've got the fish tank, and then you've got the dining area and the kitchen area here. And the kitchen area goes all the way to about here. Then you've got the freezer room here, which goes up. And then you've got the stairs. Now the stairs start about here. And because the floor's here, on this level here, you've got another floor, which is roughly along there. So that's where the yellow room is up here. And the office is up here. So this is fairly, it gives you a fairly big whack of extra space once you've floored all this. Doesn't look like it at the moment, but the thing is, if I try to decorate in here, because underneath here is a room, whenever I try to sink anything, it just disappears. You can't see it, it disappears, and it is the most frustrating thing ever. Because you've got this room here, right underneath. So it doesn't matter wherever you are, it doesn't matter what house you're in, if there is a floor, if it's not a solid floor, and you've got a room underneath, you're more likely, if you sink something, it's going to sink and disappear. And you won't be able to do it very much. It's the same with this room. If you try and sink anything upstairs, like you can do it all down on the downstairs floor, fine, you can sink everything as long as there's not a cellar underneath, and there isn't a cellar here. But if you was to try and sink anything in this room here, it would just sink through the floor and you'd lose it, you'll go invisible, and it's such an annoying thing. So that's why I decided to go up instead of out. So that is what that place looks like. And the reason why I done it like that. So yeah, as you can see, it needed to be done. I built a high just in case. I don't know if I'm a baddie, I can't remember. Could actually be a goodie. I don't remember what I am on the side. Anyway, that's why I done it that way. So this is Kian signing off for tonight, and I will see you in another video. Bye.